Hello everyone, my name is Mikhail Bortnikov. I'm a scientist at Philips Research. Today I would like to show you our work on denoising of ultra-low dose CT in the projection domain used for planning. Typical CT acquisition consists of two steps. The first is planning, it's capturing of 2D scout or so-called topogram. You may see it on the left-hand side. Then the second step, based on the captured 2D scout, radiologist sets all the parameters for the diagnostic scan, which is on the right side. Our idea is to replace 2D planning procedure with 3D planning. We can preserve the same X-ray dose using special denoising techniques. 3D information is better for dealing with overlapping organs, therefore it's beneficial for choosing parameters and reducing the overall X-ray dose. In this work, we propose a convolutional neural network for denoising of the ultra-low dose CT in the projections. We consider two data representations, line integrals and raw photon counts. More details will be given in the next slide. We used total variation denoiser as a baseline for comparison. We created a supervised dataset using special Poisson physics-related model. We simulated the CT captured with 1% dose as a training data. We train our network on overlapping patches. I would like to explain a few technical details. CT scanner captures projections and not the images. Reconstruction step converts that projections into images. Traditionally, denoising is done in image domain. However, projections are more promising because they contain redundant information, which is beneficial for denoising. In addition to this, some artifacts of images, such as streaks, are almost not possible to remove in image domain and better removable in projections. In this slide, we also show important formula. It connects photons and line integrals, which are two data representations for our trained models. Let's have a look on the training data. Here is presented line integrals, which is pretty similar to normal looking X-rays. On the top we show 1% low dose, in the middle full dose, and in the bottom is noise residual. Raw photon data looking slightly differently. It has higher dynamic range, which is beneficial for denoising because the deviation between signal and noise here is more prominent. You may see it in noise residual. As a starting point for our network, we used DNCNN. We changed it a little bit. We removed all biases and batch normalization layers. Therefore, our network became less sensitive to other noise distributions and overall more generalizable. We trained it on L1 loss. We used patch-based residual training. Let's have a look on the results. Here is presented projections denoised by our networks. Line integral CNN provides a smooth image, smooth projection, while photon CNN tends to give more sharper yet noisier projections. The same behavior remains in the image domain as well. You may see that line integral CNN tends to oversmooth image, while photon CNN gives a pretty sharp image, which contains some artifacts. And total variation denoiser underperforms in comparison to both CNNs. By metrics, line integral CNN outperforms all the other networks, which was visible from the images and projections as well. And to conclude, I want to say that we demonstrated potential to use CNNs for projections in really extremely low dose situation with only 1% dose. It's possible to get some nice looking images. And our future work will be aimed to achieve better results, maybe using slightly less aggressive dose reduction, or as well we will use alternative loss functions and different architectures. Thank you very much for your attention.